Hello and welcome back to Final Fantasy XIV Dawntrail. So on the last one, we looked around Alexandria and met with Kafkiwa, Aaronville's mother. Well, sort of. A machine that she was remotely controlling, and we're actually going to meet her in Solution 9 now. But we learned about souls, soul cells, all that stuff. So, yeah. That's it. I think we're good to go now, right? Probably. Right, Kafkiwa is waiting. Let's head to the tower. All right, and I very slightly tweaked my mic. Very, very slightly. Hopefully it's not super noticeable, but I added a little more bass to it because it's kind of getting drowned out a bit. Oh, I got two quests to do. Oh, I'm so curious about these. I'm still, once again, not going to show them because they're usually the start of a chain and stuff, but I'll let you know what these are about. Wow. There's not much to tell. Once again, a grandmother was looking for her grandchild. So yeah, we went and found her. She was under attack. And then the other one over here, this guy was looking for someone who was under attack. So nothing really worth showing there. But yeah, we saved people who were under attack. There's more to the grandmother and daughter story, but it's mostly about how the crops are failing, and she's looking into it and trying to fix it, and she's like, don't hurt yourself while doing that. That's it. I think we're good. Where's everyone else? Look at that floor. Ah, there you are. If Queen Sveen has registered you as a guest, you'll be able to march right in. And if she hasn't,
and we'll get attacked.
Then you may have a swarm of Zoralja's minions to deal with. Nothing for it but to see if Sveen has betrayed us, eh? I doubt she's betrayed us. After the cutscene we just saw. Thank you for your diligent service, friends. My companions and I would like to pass, if you'd be so kind. Now, runner, guide, unit identified, registration number verified. Six accompanying civilians identified, verifying credentials. Oh, God. Graha, you're not allowed in. Credentials verified. Welcome, guests of Sweet Queen Sveen. What a relief. There you have it. It seems the Queen was true to her word. Follow me, everyone. Solution 9 awaits. Oh boy. This is not at all how I pictured Solution. I honestly thought it was just like an ancient civilization that we were going to learn about, but not a reflection just merged with us. Oh.
Everkeep, a tower of electrope piercing a perpetual shroud of storm clouds. Occupying the ninth level of this 12-tiered structure is a residential district called Solution 9. In so naming their home, what hopes did its founders harbor for it? And did it prove the answer they sought?
Gee, that's just normal. Normal people outfits? Damn, like I actually only saw one picture of Solution 9 back at the media, not media tour, the live letter.
Spectacular, isn't it? There are more districts throughout the tower, including industrial ones, but Solution 9 is the largest.
Just being here makes my head spin.
Perfectly natural reaction. A city of shimmering electro, replete with strange technologies that cater to every conceivable need. We never dreamed of the life back home in Tuliolo.
Kona should really be here.
Now, while I go and explain the situation to those in the back room, why not take a moment to explore? I believe lived experiences are far more educational than dry explanations. And you want to know more about Sphene and Zoralgia's dominion, do you not?
You had me at explore.
I had a feeling you'd be keen.
Just to confirm, while we have been allowed inside, are we also permitted to roam?
Absolutely. As Fiend's registered guest, you'll find you're exempt from the sentry scrutiny.
The
elevator to the uppermost level. I wouldn't go near that. But other areas should be fine provided you act like you belong.
All right then, we'll show ourselves around.
Yes. Familiarizing ourselves with the technology here will help us prepare for the battles to come.
Yeah, that's why.
Try not to enjoy yourselves too much, or you're liable to attract attention.
Once you've explored to your satisfaction, come to the entrance to True View in the Eastern Sector. The way from there is a little complicated, so I'll send someone to guide you.
Understood. We'll see you later.
Why? This would have been so surprising to see. Why did they show this in the live letter?
I shall speak with the residents. Perhaps one of them will recognize the earring.
Right, Kryle might be from here, even. Maybe.
What's with this place? How can this all be the inside of a tower?
So, what aren't you telling me? Where are you?
That I can't reveal yet. Precautions, you understand. Just know that I'm safe. But come, tell me about your adventurer friend. You seem to have a great deal of faith in her. You must have been through a lot together.
Well,
you might say that. For instance, we found the entrance to the Golden City.
I was worried she was going to be like, what? What Golden City? And then...
You want to explore together?
And prove she's wrong. Obviously.
It's not that I'm scared or anything. Everything is just so different from home is all.
Why do we look so devastated? That's my child. Yeah, why did they reveal this in the live letter? Like the second that I saw this, if you go back at all and watched like the first live letter, you can tell when I stopped following any Dawntrail news. The second they showed the first photo of Solution 9, I'm like, whoa, what the? And then I literally clicked out and vowed to not watch anything else. Outside of the job action trailer. I really wanted to see that, but this would have been so great. This would have been equal to Amarat in like the what scale had you not shown it in the trailer. I don't know why they did it, but damn. Oh, it doesn't look as big as I was thinking it was going to. Is there multiple floors or? It doesn't look like it. Well, that's fine. Looks, I mean, it's way bigger. Like the background is way bigger, and that looks like my PS5. Well, kind of. Never mind. No, it doesn't. All right, Wukumat, we have to go around. We gotta explore this place. Towers inside a tower. I see it, but I still can't believe it. For now, I say we proceed straight ahead. If we feel like we're getting lost, we can always turn around and go back the way we came. Leander. Oh, look at these shards. Yeah, the picture I saw, the very first one they showed, I don't know if they actually showed more than that. I just know that I clicked out the second they showed it. So, there was no people. I think it was, they showed one of these. So, that was already just like a wait, billboards and stuff, which makes more sense than you think if you've seen like FF13 or anything. This city isn't that out of place for like Eden in FF14. 13. Welcome to Solution 9. Can I help you or interest you in a packet of angel snacks? Angel snacks? They're all the rage at the moment. That's a blue mage ability. Well, it's also, what the hell does that do? Isn't that a heal that like an AoE absorb? AoE heal? AoE. Oh, yeah, I haven't used it in a long time. FF9. Angel Snack uses remedy on all party members. Good old Quina. Karina. We pride ourselves on stocking a beverage for every occasion. Feeling lousy and lethargic? Need a quaffable cure for your ailments? Look no further. From tonics to medicine and everything in between, we have it all. Why are we not actually escorting Wuklamat? We don't get to run around with her? Okay, they have flying cars. What? I mean, why were they not here? I'm totally ignoring the fact that she said just go straight. I'll turn around as soon as I get here. Or get to this. Can we get housing here? Oh my god, these couches! Hold on. Okay. Interesting. Well, I guess there would be an inn here, right? Is this gonna be the inn? That one's blue. Whoa. Everything's so fancy. I don't know what I'm looking at there. Hey, oh man, that is. Is that new furnishings coming? Please? Oh man. Oh! Yeah, chocobo one? Oh man. I need this. I don't know whose house I'm in right now, but. Oh. If you could get like these, but then like put custom lettering on your own version. I don't know what that's supposed to be. Oh, hell yeah. What the? Don't tell me this is like a toilet or something. What? What is going on with that? What is that? Those look like speakers placed right next to each other. I don't know if that's the most ideal way to do it, but... Okay. Anything else over to see here? This is so... You got elevators, I see. Are there elevators anywhere else in the game? I think that's exclusive to this. You got injured at work? Just a scratch. Besides, as a hunter, it comes with the territory. How could you live outside in Alexandria with this in here? That's such a different lifestyle. It's crazy. And they're so close to each other. All right, up on this walkway, this definitely looks like FF. Well, I guess FF13 too. Is it called New Eden? What the hell is that place called? Oh, totally different place. Eden was before, that was FF13. FF13 too had Academia, which very much, I feel like that's a little bit what they're going for here. It's like an Academia vibe. Or Academia, whatever you want, however you want to put it, but yeah. Absolutely, like, when I saw that in FF13 2 for the first time, I was like, wow, like that. I love just random sci-fi in a fantasy setting. I don't know why. Oh, hey, sweet, sweet coffee. Hey, you guys are living the life here. Just leave me be. I got absolutely fleeced today. Got vending machines. How loud is that? It's already at 19. You know what? For a little bit, I'll go up extra. I don't even know what song this. This reminds me of Trails games music. All the residents' radii are laid out like this. Residential radii, I think. That's what you... with gardens right outside the entrance. I love coming here to relax. Today's great. Technology's great. But we'll always need trees and plants, you know. Forgot how to talk. Oh my god. Clerk! Current location, residential radius of 914, a section 02. Visitors must be equipped with a regulator or present a valid visitor permit. The permit. Oh, we're going to have a story event here. I'll just come back. Clearly, we're getting our own rooms. All right, we're going to head up there. Can we mountain here? No, we can't. Damn. Wait, so we can't mount in Tuliolol or here. That's a first. No, it's not. No, it's not. I ignore me. You can't mount in Razadhan or Charlian either. I was just thinking of Ralgar's Reach for some reason, and oh, you can't do it in Yulmor in Crystarium either. Why did they ever... This is a big one. Oh god. Don't fall. I don't know why they don't add mounts to certain areas. Crossroads already. This place is too much. No idea where I should go. Let's go right. Right. I made up my mind. Let's head to that building there. That's left. Is there like a jump pad up to there? Yeah. What the... You know what? We're no longer fighting right now.
are! La Mati!
Sphine!
I was worried you might have had trouble at the checkpoint, but I see everything went according to plan.
Well, that's thanks to you.
Why'd they choose this song of all songs?
Now, I know you've scarcely arrived, but I have a request to make of you.
Oh, a request, you say?
Yes, an important one.
I can't even guess what it's going to be. Unless it's, please kill Zoraldra.
I'll say it plain. I want you to make peace with Zoraldra.
The opposite of what I said.
What? I thought you said you weren't on his side.
We have come no closer to seeing eye to eye, nor do I condone his methods. Be that as it may, I don't want you to fight him. I don't want you to regret a decision made in anger and haste. Unequipped with regulators as you are, the risk is too great.
I appreciate your concern, but you ask the impossible. Zoraldra murdered our father. His minions slaughtered our countrymen. He will never renounce his war. As vow of resolve, it falls to me to stop him. I know you love your people too, and so you must understand how I feel, why I cannot, will not back down.
I do understand all too well. Let me say only this then. Zoraldra will use any means to win. If you would protect your people, return to them at once and prepare. Prepare as best you can. It may ring hollow coming from the queen of an enemy nation. But unlike me, you still have the power to determine your own fate.
You really are a curious one. Look, you needn't worry for us. We have dependable comrades holding the fort in Tulihyolal. They'll keep everyone safe, so we can devote our attention to affairs here.
Please.
I guess this is because he did say he'd slaughter her people too, or his own people now, technically. Never fear, I'll be there alongside her.
So you have comrades on whom you can rely. I envy you.
You know, we'd like to learn more about you.
About me?
To be frank, we're still not sure whether or not you're trustworthy. So, if you have a moment, would you show us around the district? That way, we can get to know you better.
You're asking me, the queen, to show you around?
Hell yeah. She's a queen too, kind of.
Oh, but I jest. I'm flattered that you've taken an interest in me. Very well, I shall be your guide. You're my guests, after all, and teaching you about my realm would be a pleasure in and of itself. If you like, I can introduce you to my citizens, too. I consider them family, as you do yours.
By all means, we're in your capable hands.
That you are. This will be an enjoyable and enlightening tour, I promise.
Kinda trust her. Sort of. Alright. We are very much out of place here, though. Wait, what? Oh, we've hit nighttime theme. Okay. This is such a different vibe. Also, it's so weird that this place, the way it looks, would have to call it her realm and that she would be a queen. More like president. Misfiend is our guide. We needn't fear getting lost. The Queen's Tour. Let's begin then, shall we? I must say, I'm really grateful. This place is so vast and confusing, I didn't even know where to begin. While the district may seem daunting in size, all the key facilities are situated near ley nodes? What you call aetherites. Oh. Remember this and you won't lose your way. What is... Now then, seeing as it is right here, I'll show you next to the Nexus Arcade first. Please follow me. Arcade? Oh. There's a delivery Moogle. Okay, it's a mall. This complex is home to all manner of shops, from food and daily necessities to technological conveniences. You can find most everything here. Every Everkeep's interior is vast, as you've observed. This arcade makes it possible for people to acquire what they need in one centralized location. Why is it called an arcade, though? Amazing. How do you get to the upper levels? I don't see the stairs. Oh, God. Do you see the glowing pattern over yonder? That is an automatic conveyor. Such contraptions are found throughout Everkeep, allowing us to swiftly move between faraway places. That will spare us some walking, and they also made them Are they also made from the strange metal? Alec, what's it? Yes, the conveyors are powered by electro. As a matter of fact, the ore is integrated into just about everything in Everkeep, even the floors and walls. By etching arcane circuits upon it, electro can be used to convert lightning energy to those of other elements. In doing so, we can achieve various effects. For instance, a conversion to wind produces flotation. Oh, that's cool. Which is required for the propulsion of our flying vehicles. A conversion to fire, meanwhile, produces light and heat, and it is employed in devices such as street lamps and heaters. There are even self-heating cups that keep your drink warm. Can I live here? Can you make a drink cold if you convert it to ice instead? Now you're getting it. You certainly can. Our vending machines do just that. What's more, multiple energies can also be combined to produce some clever effects. For instance, by manipulating the air with wind, while projecting light with lightning, it is possible to alter one's appearance? How does that work? It's almost scary what you can do with electrope. If such a wondrous material existed in our world, I imagine everyone would be fighting over it. Okay. Is that what was happening before this place got, like, moved in out of their reflection? Everyone was fighting over Electro? Because right now it doesn't seem like everyone's united here, obviously. There's one kingdom that got pulled. This shop over here, what does it sell? Ah, yes, let's go and take a look. I dare say you will find it interesting. Why did you look right at me for that? This is so weird. Oh, yeah. Oh, is the hangout spot then? The mall? Collectible appraiser? Okay. Oh, what the hell is this? Oh, no. What do I can give for a capable tradeswoman? Wait, 90 or above? I'm not gonna do that right now. Definitely not right now. But you look kind of like Rowena, Rotina. Oh, okay. I see what they're going for. Clearly. What's all this? Welcome, miss. Care to peruse today's selection? Don't know what any of that is. This shop sells food, and those are the items on the counter. Oh. It's like ration. That's food? I can't imagine what they taste like. I thought you might be surprised. Your countrymen were too big. Were too in the beginning. Come, you must sample something. Choose one, and I will purchase it. Do you use gill for some odd reason? Welcome, friends. How lucky are you for Her Majesty to treat you? The five items on display are most popular. I recommend one of them, if it's your first time. Do I get to look at all five? Is that going to be the thing? Select an item that interests you. Black and yellow tin? What the hell's in there? Hexagon patterned bag? Long rectangle? Liquid filled pouch? What are the pink hexagons? I'll be honest, the thing that interests me most is the pink hexagons. Are they grapes? They look like grapes. The synthetic fruit pellets. They're our best approximation of the taste and texture of grape. There you go. I've never tried the real fruit, so I can't say how faithful they are, but there's no denying their popularity. We can read about all of them. Nah, the revivifying tonic. I take it you're thirsty. The flavor is a sublime blend of sweet and salty, and it stays fresh for over 10 years thanks to the special container. That makes sense. Keen on a perfect meal bar, are you? All the nutrients your body needs packed into a single foodstuff. The flavor is formulated to never taste dull. And one bar will satisfy you for the whole day. Many folks prefer this to taking multiple meals. You know what? This guy's just Tanaka. I'm gonna give him Tanaka. Nah, yes, the salad paste. This is designed for those who are concerned about their figure. With its blend of 9 varieties of vegetables, it'll help your efforts to slim down. Fashion models swear by it, and youths can't get enough of the stuff either. Black and yellow tin. This here's a cultivated steak. It's not quite the same as the real thing they produce in the outskirts, but it's a sight more affordable. This particular product is known as Gold Label, and it's a delicious hybrid of beef and chicken grown at the plant on the fourth level. Actually, yes. That sounds good. Not that it matters. I can't eat it. I'm very hungry, though. Well, they're all very tempting. I'm gonna have to have the steak like you, Rin. I'm absolutely starving. Thank you for your custom. This being Her Majesty's treat, it's bound to taste all the better. Say, would you mind sampling your selection here and now? It's been a long time since we had newcomers, and I'd love to see your reactions. Oh no, they're all emotional vampires. This is a great chance to learn about Alexandrian culture, Rin. Let's dig in. I'm an emotional vampire, too. More so than I am at showing my emotions. That's why I can't wait for grinding gear to get here now. All right, here we go. Here I go. What am I doing? Following our lead, you sample your selection. Amazing. I've never had any meat like this before. It's tender like chicken, but flavorsome like Ronik, and the spices give it just the right amount of kick. I could eat this every day. Don't mind them. They're just happy to see your honest reactions. And how about you? Let's try to just shit on it. I want to see how they react. I have a feeling this is going to be meta. It's pretty good. Oh, they were not as happy about that. Disappointing reaction there. It's always such a pleasure. My thanks for humoring me. This does take me back. Though it was chaotic when the people of Tuliola first arrived, we endeavored to learn about one another and embrace our differences. Ah, right. What about you, Sveen? Are you having something to eat, too? I appreciate the thought, but I'm fine for now. Thank you.
What do you not eat?
All right, but what's your favorite food, if you don't mind me asking? My favorite food? Why do you wish to know?
You're a robot.
Because I wanted to get to know you better. Why else? The more you know someone, the more you grow fond of them. That's what my old man believed, and my experiences have led me to believe the same. My favorite food? Is it such a difficult question?
Apparently.
I'm sorry, it's just when I think of those who labor to bring us food, I can't find I settle on one thing. I thought I was indecisive, but you're something else. Indecisive? Perhaps I am, but you didn't need to laugh about it.
Maybe she is a little bit like Garnet. What the? There's a Mamulja here?
My favorite food? That is a question I may never be able to answer.
Definitely not in public either, otherwise, because everyone would immediately say, screw the rest of it, we're eating what the queen eats.
Okay. I don't know about you, but I'm satisfied. Let's keep moving. Very well. Next, I was thinking of showing you the residential sector, but it's in part so I can tend to personal matters. It's a visitation, to be precise, and I believe it'll be educational for you as well. Would the two of you mind accompanying me? Not at all. Wonderful. Let me know when you've seen enough here and we'll make our way.
Hold then. Oh, these are the world fates rewards? Is this, I'm good. Yeah, no. Not a fan of those.
Got new gear yet? 98 gear?
Ooh, yes.
Okay. What's the die on this? Die too.
Ooh, that one's real. A lot of it is a dieable.
Okay.
Okay, and that one's the same. Basically the same. It looks a little more leather. Okay. That one's interesting. I don't really like the shoulder, but... Wait, no, aiming. Ah, it's the same. All right, what about casters? I just want to see. That looks familiar. Are these reskins? I feel like they might be reskins, and I just don't remember trying them on. Oh, my character breathes a lot more than they used to, I swear. They could be reskins. Wait, I don't recognize that at all. Oh. Okay. And weapons. Oh my god, these are pretty sweet too. Try greatsword. Oh. What the? I like that one. I don't like that it's too thin at the bottom. I feel like it should be thick all the way down and then like the, yeah. But either way, this is a pretty cool weapon. All right, and then I'm just going to try bow and we'll get out of here. Ah, I've seen this model before. What is this from? I think that's actually a level 50 poetic bow. Or at least similar to this, at the very least. Maybe not exactly like this, but I remember that circle on a different weapon and like these points being really weird like that. Okay. Gemstone. I hate to turn away a customer, but I'm still getting set up. Well. Hello there. I'm afraid we aren't open for business. Nonetheless, we look for your customs in the future. What are you going to sell? Air Wheeler Dealer. Holy shit. Is this the first? Ow. I don't think I've ever seen a mount for sale and like a reason to actually have money. That's a lot of money. That's actually awesome. Like this, I can't describe how rare this actually is to have like something this price in the game. Because everything else is like, no, you got to do like 100 fates to get this one. And like all money is for is buying a house. Outside of that, why have money? There's no point. If they start adding stuff like this, then people have a reason to like actually try to earn money. I'm broke, obviously. I'm always broke, so I'm never going to be able to afford that. But still. That is a welcome addition, in my opinion. Ready? Let's head to the residential sector. It lies to the southwest. As we walk, I would be glad to tell you of all the places of interest that we come upon. Hold on. Oh, now they're escorting. Yeah. Still 97. Sights of the West and Beyond. Oh. Oh. Her sister. Right. When I unlock the sightseeing log, she's like, yeah, you might run into my sister at some point. I was like, well, that doesn't matter because you already discussed things with her and then gave me her sightseeing log info. But apparently, she got pulled into here. I assume. Which means we have to do that before we can actually see these sightseeing logs. What's going on here? Mosaic? Oh my god, it's a coffee shop. And then I nearly drove the hover car. Idiot, what would have happened if you crashed the company? If you crashed? Welcome to Mosaic, a place for folks from all walks of life to mingle and mesh like the patterned stones of a... Well, you get the picture. If you like coffee, I recommend our original blend. All right, Oh, I have to talk to you too. That meat was so good. I have to get everyone at home to try it. This is Mosaic, a cafe. Here you can buy drinks to enjoy while you relax. I see. In Tuliolol, there's a similar establishment called Jval Yavtaye. That's seashell in the local tongue. Is there a story behind the name Mosaic? There is. In our continent, the races are named for stones. There's the Hyun, who resemble the Tonawata, the tall and graceful Eldite, and the diminutive and affable Milala? When they're all gathered here, they appear as a mosaic of colors. Thus did the founder choose the name of to name the cafe. That's nice. If they serve tacos here, it'd be perfect. Tacos? A traditional Torali dish, and one of my favorite foods. You must try it one day. Yes, definitely. We'll make it happen once we've restored peace to Tuliolol. Right, let's continue on. I gotta turn this down slightly. Oh, I didn't talk to you normally, though. Whoa! Have you eaten these tacos before? For Lamati to recommend them so highly, they must be delicious. Maybe? Wait, did I ever grab that? Give me a sec. I did not. Alright, then we can just shortcut over here. So the races are named after rocks. And she's also named after as the Queen's Fiend. Interesting. Also off of Garnet. And here we are. These buildings are where our citizens live. They're massive. Each one is bigger than the palace. Oh yeah, I can't even see the top. They have to be, for just about all Alexandrians have apartments here. Unless you wonder, I'm here to visit people. The apartment is in the building on the left here at 914. Residential radius. That's right, come. The doors open automatically. I mean, assuming that, you know, the tower goes all the way around. You'd have to, like, separate them by radius, within this radius. This is a lobby, a common area for residents. I see, and what does that machine there do? Ah, the concierge. They look after residents. If you require assistance or have questions, they'd be glad to assist. Is that so? I have no shortage of questions, but I'll direct them at you for now. By all means, you may consider me your personal concierge. Hey, Sveen, can anyone live in this place? Naturally. In fact, many of your countrymen make their homes here. No matter your origin or race, occupation, or regulator usage, all Alexandrian citizens are eligible for an apartment. This includes those you've met who work on the outskirts. You've taken care of everyone for 30 years. I'm truly, truly grateful. Who are we visiting? Is the place. A mother and son live here. Voiced? Nope. Hello, Isadora. Your Majesty, you came. I have friends with me today. Is that all right? Of course. Friends of the Queen are friends of ours. Please make yourself at home. How has Milos been? There's been no change, but the symptoms are thankfully mild today.
Hello, Milos. Have you missed me? My son was born with Levin sickness, a severe etheric imbalance towards lightning. As a result, he suffers from paralysis. He cannot walk and struggles to speak. For a blessing, he still has his hearing, and even on bad days, he can communicate with his eyes. I see. This fiend visits often, does she? She does. Milo simply adores her. He sometimes even manages a smile when she's here. What of yourself, Isadora? How are you holding up? You needn't worry about me, Your Majesty. You always make time for us, and we have everything we need. I'm glad to hear it, but you mustn't strain yourself, understood? There's nothing you can do for him, but perhaps a treatment with souls or... Unfortunately, no. While souls can revive those who have met with an accident, they cannot reverse the effects of old age and illness. Truth be told, many children are born like Milos. The illness has existed for generations, and we've been unable to find a cure. Oh. Oh, we can fix that. With Graha knowledge. The cause is quite clear, though. The excess lightning in the environment. It's no coincidence the number of cases has risen dramatically these past 30 years. It's all my fault. What was that? I'm sorry, Isadora, but I must be going. I promise to make a proper visit next time, with treats to share. There's no need to apologize, Your Majesty. If it weren't for you, Milos and I wouldn't still be here. Thank you. Oh, thank you, Queen Sveen. It's my pleasure, Milos. I'll be back soon, so be a good boy for your mother and for me. Okay, we learned about an illness here. To think that there was such an illness. My thanks for accompanying me on the visit. The illness is a part of life in Alexandria, and I thought you should know about it. You'll find a cure one day, mark my words. We'll make it so unfortunate children like Milo's smile again. Oh. Oh, hey. Quests are 98 now, right as I leveled up. Her people, her family. Well, let's continue the tour, shall we? Look, you've obviously have duties to attend to, citizens to look after. We can stop here if you like. No, I do this because I want to, so please do not worry. Next, I'll show you one of the district's most vital facilities, a place called Resolution. To reach it, we need to go by way of Lanode 9, where the Aetherite is situated. A lot of 9 references. Important facility, 9. Solution, 9. Is there any actual lore to Zidane's trance dying abilities? Or are they just named it because Solution 9 sounded like a cool name? It's not even his best move, right? It's his second best? Oh, I don't remember. Wait, we never went over here, though. That's the raid. I know the name of the raid coming out. We're definitely going there later. I remember Kafkiwa said we're meeting at True View, so I'm gonna wait to go there. I'm gonna story for now. What about the second half of Heritage Found? How do we even get to that?
Don't tell me we need to use that now. The conveyor ahead will transport you to the government sector, where resolution is located. The markings on the conveyor indicate its direction, and there is a pair just like it on the other side. Oh, speaking of, is it safe? Extremely. There's no need to be afraid. Who said I was afraid? Come on, Rin. Wait, I never actually checked the conveyor over here. Is that it? Where did they say it was? Ah, there it is right there. I need to go check this for sure. I can't just leave this unexplored. Also, it kind of looks like there's a material. There might be NPC. Whoa. How did that happen? We just like digitized. Oh my god, this is so... There's no way I'm not AFKing here all the time. Oh yeah, 11s. I have like... Wait, can I check that? I got 5 of these already from Gunbreaker dailies. 18 crit? Oof. 54 crit? Okay. They look a little strange. Why is that on the top? I don't even know how you look at the old ones, but you can. Okay. Item level 690. Gotcha. I reckon I'll buy a new work desk. Can we go in here? No. All right. Oh. Government sector. I can't believe I thought this was a zone. And like a, you know, a normal zone. This zone. I thought Solution 9 was just going to be a massive this. What's going on over there? Why is it so empty? I don't see anything. I don't think anything's not loaded over there. I think there's no reason to go over there. Nothing to it, eh? A child's amusement ride. And here we are, Resolution, the operational heart of Solution 9. From Resolution, we oversee the running of the district and provide essential services to citizens, such as welfare support and job introductions. It's quicker to show than tell, so let us proceed inside. I can't read that. Did I say Hot Topic?
Strange contraptions everywhere you look. What's that?
An infusion station. It dispenses souls in exchange for credits. Through hard work, citizens can obtain the peace of mind provided by spare souls. It's the way of life for Alexandrians, and has been for quite some time. But I imagine it must be difficult for outsiders to comprehend.
That's putting it lightly. To be honest, it sounds disturbing. Still, I won't dismiss it out of hand. Practices like these don't arise from nothing.
That's true.
There's a reason why your culture is the way it is, and I'd like to understand. Won't you tell us some of your realm's history?
Yep. Why don't you keep looking to me? I'm keen to learn too.
Very well. Be warned, though, that it may take a while.
I didn't get a cutscene warning.
In the distant past, over 1,000 years ago, it said, lightning energy began to swell in our world. According to ancient records that date back around 8 centuries, the rainy season spanned a quarter of the year, during which time severe thunderstorms ravaged the land. 4 centuries later, this season had lengthened to nearly half the year. The trend continued, with our ancestors spending longer and longer languishing beneath storm clouds. Crops failed and livestock starved. But amidst this growing desperation, a miraculous material was discovered that promised salvation. Electrope.
The stuff that's used everywhere here.
Indeed. One day, when out inspecting a forest after lightning had caused a fire, a villager came upon a curious black ore none had seen before. Testing revealed that the ore possessed a singular property. It could store lightning and convert it to other energies. In that instant, the scourge of endless storms became a blessing. Dubbed Electrope, the ore found use in myriad inventions and dramatically improved people's lives. So much so, in fact, that all nations soon became dependent upon it, despite the difficulty of obtaining it in quantity. Supply was chronically scarce, and when nations couldn't meet their needs with their own deposits, some resorted to taking electrope from others. Fighting was isolated and sporadic, until electrope came to be used in warfare. First in the weaponry of invaders, then in the countermeasures of defenders, and then in every aspect of combat where an advantage might be had. This served only to exacerbate the ore shortage, leading to further escalation. Before long, the entire world was engulfed in a terrible war known as the Storm Surge.
Ooh. Storm Surge.
As the war came to a head, Alexandria's neighbor, Lindblom, committed its stores of electrope to the production of a weapon of mass destruction. They deployed it on the front lines and triggered a calamity of frightful magnitude. Not even their own scientists had anticipated the force of the lightning that was unleashed. The energy inundated the entire continent, laying it to waste.
So that's how your world came to be this way.
Look. Okay. Okay. I need to double check this quick. Wait, can I not? Oh, I have to hit enter first. So in this reality, Lindblom triggered a calamity? That's like the opposite of FF9's Lindblom. Like, Cid would have went out of his way to stop it, and Alexandria would have been the one to cause it. Interesting. Yeah, it does sound like a number of calamity. Did it actually happen? Is this one of the because the reflection, this part of the reflection could have got out in time. And the only ones safe right now are the, I forgot already. 1st, 4th, 8th, 9th, and 11th? Am I right? Actually, I don't know. But I don't know what element they're attached to. I don't remember which elements haven't been rejoined.
You truly know a great many things that I don't. I should like to learn about you too sometime.
You have a better time with Graha, actually.
But to continue the tale, the people of Alexandria had already lost much to the war. They lost almost everything else to the Levin. Those who survived bore deep scars, tormented by the memory of loved ones taken too soon. Though they yet lived, the cruel specter of death was with them always. Seeking a solution, our scientists turned once more to Electrope, and after extensive research, they developed the means to preserve memory and soul. Physical death isn't the end. So long as our memories endure, we may live on. This belief sustained us then, and it sustains us now, granting us comfort.
That's quite a tale.
Your Majesty, help me, I beg you, help me.
What's the matter?
I've got no souls left. Not a single one. But the lot at Soul Supply refused to give me any. Please, you must do something.
My apologies, Your Majesty. This man, he does no work. Instead, he drinks his days away on Trueview. He has only himself to blame if he has no credits for souls.
That's not true. I'm a fighter at the Arcadian. Or rather, I was. I haven't been allowed to fight because of the king's decree. It isn't my choice.
Oh, is it a coliseum?
I see. You're a brave warrior of the arena. I want to help you, I sincerely do, but I cannot give you preferential treatment.
Then open up the Arcadian again, so I can fight!
I'm sorry, but that's not my decision to make. The king requires feral souls for war. He doesn't wish for them to be expended on amusements.
Huh.
You're useless! A queen in naught but name!
Insolent wretch! How dare you take that tone with Her Majesty?
It's quite all right. Such things don't bother me, nor do I think ill of this man. Hear me. Though I cannot grant you a soul, I mean it when I say I want you to live. I love all of you equally, dearly. You are as family to me, and it pains me to see you deny yourself hope. I want you to find a happiness all your own, even if you must grow it from the smallest seed of joy. Out there, somewhere, is a reason for you to smile again. We all need to vent our frustrations from time to time. I will always be willing to lend an ear.
Yes, Mum. Of course.
Oh.
Even without a spare soul, I suppose I'm fine as long as I stay in Solution 9. I apologize for my rudeness. Good day to you.
I guess
Keep your chin up, my friend! And when you feel better, I'm sure you'll find another way to apply your talents.
Be a real thing for people around here, I guess. The worry of no souls after you've relied on it, and you just be fearing death all the time.
I'm sorry you had to see that. Let's keep moving, shall we?
I don't know why they zoomed into her the way they did, and then she laughed. It makes me think evil, but not.
Right.
I don't think so.
I believe we visited all the main facilities. With that, I declare our tour concluded.
That man from before, does that sort of thing happen often?
Somewhat. It's unavoidable. Hardships are a fact of life. Our soul management system has sustained our realm for generations, but it isn't without flaws. For one, people have become accustomed to having spare souls. Without them, they feel vulnerable and anxious. Some claim it may also have contributed to a decline in births.
Just thinking out loud, but would it be possible to do away with the system?
No.
No.
I know it isn't easy to change one's beliefs and way of life. The Mamulja had their reasons for their reliance on blessed siblings, much as you have yours for souls. But if we defeated Zorolja, you'd be able to make all the decisions, right? Then we could work together to fix things, restore your realm to where it belongs, and see where we can go from there.
Listen to me. There's something that I need to tell you.
Okay, good. Oh, damn it.
What is it?
Actually, never mind. It's nothing of import. Well, it was lovely showing you around.
Of course. Thanks so much for the tour. We've learned not only about your realm, but you as well. For now, our priority is Zorolja. But once we've dealt with him, perhaps I can return the favor and show you to Lihyolal.
I'd like that very much.
Oh boy. Yeah. The determined face there. Damn it, you gotta stop hiding it.
It seems I've no choice but to continue down this path. Forgive me, Vow Wuklamart, but I must disappoint you.
Is that necklace is fiend? Okay. If she just said something, what was it that, what was Sveen wanting to tell us, I wonder? That's, well, we'll never know. Unfortunately. Well, it can wait for another time. We've been exploring for a while now, and we should probably go to Kafkiwa's meeting point. That'll be back the way we came, I think. It's right over there. This place that looks insane. Look at all these colors. Oh, Wait, no. No way I'm not going in here and checking stuff. Verifying registration, verification complete. Welcome, guests of Queen's Fiend. This is Resolution, the operational center of Solution 9. If you have queries, present them at the counter inside. Okay. How long is this going to take? What do you do with this? Tell me. Welcome to the government sector. This facility deals with matters pertaining to employment and welfare. Please let me know if you require assistance. Yeah. Cadmus. This is the place to come if you've got issues with work and whatnot. I'm getting married, so I thought I'd try to wrangle a better paid position. It has to be worth the shot, right? I mean, unless you get fired for trying, then yeah, worth a shot. This is just going to be elevators? Yeah, elevators. Had to check, of course. All right, what's up with you? This is the elevator hall. I'm afraid only authorized individuals are allowed access. Thank you for your understanding. Feldspar! I found him! I'm glad they approved my housing request, but when I went to move in, there was somebody still living there. You should have seen the official's face when I told them what happened. Huh. Alright, and then we'll check over here. Damn it, I can't jump the counter. I'm next. Can I go over here and grab some souls? And then just release them? Just freak them back into the ethereal sea? Amaryllis. Here we manage the distribution and exchange of soul cells. If you give me a moment, I can confirm your details and regulatory status. It appears you aren't registered in the citizen database. I couldn't read that. Oh boy. Well, this is a pleasure indeed. Care for a little chat, stranger? What do you do? Me? I'm but a simple mother and housekeeper here in the city. Well, since my children were awarded government positions and promptly flew the nest, there's not a whole lot of mothering left to do. Since I retired, I seem to have altogether too much time on my hands. So, I while away the days chatting with passerbys such as yourself.
Oh.
What kind of place is this? This place is known as Solution 9, an impressively large feat of engineering, even when compared to Everkeep's elevation, 11 other levels.
Really?
City is home to all sorts of facilities. Civic advisory services, bustling markets, countless shops and retailers, the list goes on. Apparently there's even a sector where you can find less than official goods. Either way, for we citizens, there's nary a problem that lacks a solution, hence the name. The cleaners do a marvelous job of keeping the streets tidy, and all our needs are met. Solution 9 really is a spectacular place to live. Perhaps you'd consider making the city your home, too?
I don't know. Solution 9 just sounds like a military plan. Plan number 9, to destroy everyone.
Sphine genuinely cares for her people. I can respect her for that. And thanks to her tour, I've come to better understand the lives of Alexandrians. They don't feel so strange and distant anymore.
Scales of blue. Oh yeah, we had a little child following us.
So we're supposed to go to a place called True Vu in the Eastern Sector. This conveyor ought to take us there. You know, once you get used to it, they're actually kind of fun. Come on, Rin.
I mean, look at me. I'm digitized. That would scare me. What if you don't get all your parts back? What if I'm missing an ear? Okay, this is like a parking garage.
Okay, they're up top. I'm going to talk to
Elsby's sister. I think that was her name, right? Elsby?
If it's not her, that would be insane. Emmeline Ironheart. Oh, your sister. I thought they were twins, but yeah, it's been 30 years, I guess. That tome, that wouldn't happen to be a sightseeing log, would it? Millith, now that's a name I haven't heard in a good long time, and dearest Elsby, she's my twin sister, you see, and I haven't seen her for 30 long years, not since I was trapped during my exploration of Iasulani. Oh my god. It brings me great joy to know she is well. Pardon me for asking, but might I see those notes? She added. This is interesting. Like, I don't know. She always did make such bold strokes of her lettering. Here. I'm going to go talk to her, actually. I've added my notes. Some of the information may seem improbable at best, but I believe there is truth in every entry. Were I younger, I would set out in search of these fantastic sights myself, but alas, my body can no longer endure such travels. Though thanks to you, I feel lighter than I have in ages. There's one thing I should wish, it's to see my sister again before I die. There is so much I would share with her. But you have better things than to attend to than an old woman's musings. Take care, kind adventurer, and may your journey lead you to vistas both bright and unforgettable. New sightseeing. That is just crazy. Hold on. I'm going back to her. I just need to, the hell? Is there like a little alleyway here? Oh. I'll go back to her after I get that. This is the right place, you think? I don't know. I can't read anything. I don't see the others, though. Well, that rather than sitting and waiting, we might as well explore a bit. Huh? Rin, look over there. A Mamulja child. What are they doing here? Are there any other Mamuljas? We haven't seen a single one. He's gone. He's blue. Okay, you noticed it too, right? The resemblance to Zoralja. He did not have a kid. The blue scales of a Bunewa with the features of a Hubigo. This can't be a coincidence. At any rate, it wouldn't do to leave such a small child on their own. How? Come on, let's go after them. Maybe that was part of the remaking of things? She created him a son? Because obviously there's no way a non-Mamulja would be able to birth them. Holy sh! What the? Ah. There's the graphics card everyone was talking about then. That's the Arcadian? Oh, goddamn. I have no idea what the raid story is going to be about this tier, but I'm... I mean, from now on, I'm definitely making videos for everything, so I will show everything first time stuff. So, yeah, Gunbreaker. Lined with bars and fighting stadiums, True View is considered the finest entertainment district in Everkeep. This district's current name is based on the popular idea that only those who gather in its back alley streets see the truth of the world. Staid and uninspired, its unofficial name has seemingly long since fallen out of use. Alright, I'm gonna look around here after. Oh my god. This place is awesome. I'm just gonna grab this and go talk to Elspie quick. I wanna know if any dialogue changed. What a weird feeling coming back to this after where we just were. Oh, yay! Well, not yay, but what? My poor sister's trapped inside that strange dome. Thank you. This is precisely the lead I've been searching for. Now I just need to find a way inside. You do that. But it'll never happen. Oh, I'm going to keep up with it. The problem is this isn't a quest, so she's probably never going to move. But now she knows. So we can assume that canonically she probably... She probably went to, you know... Someday she will go see her sister. She wanted to see her before she dies. All right. Sorry, I was just too curious about that. I had to. All right, before we look around anymore, we've got a Mamulja to chase. I think they ran this way. They're still there. Don't worry. Down here. Whoa, chipmunk, squirrel. So this is true view. I'm not sure what I'm looking at, but it does seem lively. How is this going to be a raid? I have no idea how it could. That building's just about the only one that isn't lit up. Not open for business at the moment, I guess. Like, what if we're legit just going in there and our goal is to win a tournament? An 8-person tournament, that's it. That seems, tame. Ah! I didn't see you there. Listen, we don't mean you any harm. We just want to talk. Does he not know how to talk? It's a bit odd, don't you think? They run off when we approach, only to suddenly reappear. Could it be they want to take us somewhere? Is that the way of it? You want us to follow you? So it is. All right, then. Lead the way. Well, one was running from us, and this one walked up, so that makes me think that there are two. There's no reason for him to come back after. You got a sibling? Let's see where they take us. Oh, yeah. Wuklamot's accompanying me, and I'm following him. Gotcha. What do you got to say about this? Let's try not to lose sight of him. Oh, wait. Are you stopping for me? Oh, no. I think he just stopped in general. Oh, my God. This is... I think this might be even more sci-fi than 13-2 was. I think this is a step above the academia. Coffee place? Oh, that looked like a Cerberus on the map. Melancholy. Song is always too quiet. Is this where you wanted to bring us? What is this place? If you're meant to relax here, it isn't working for me. Hey, what's your name? His name is No. So you're still not inclined to talk. He'll only talk if he's completely comfortable with you. You know him? After a fashion, but never mind that. How about something to wet your whistle? Adorable as you are, it's on the house. I can recommend our special, Her Majesty. I'll prepare one with liquor for the boy. Without liquor for the boy, too. Her Majesty. No? What? Thanks, but no thanks. We're supposed to meet a friend named Kafkiwa. We ran into the child on our way, and he led us here. Oh, so you're with Kafkiwa. No, shit. What do you think they call their link pearls around here? In that case, go and have a chat with with Big Tassos there. He'll show you to a fun place. Is everyone else already in there? What about him? I don't think he's in the mood to talk, so he can tend the bar with me. This is taking a turn for the strange, but you don't think we're walking into a trap, do you? I think there's about a 30% chance of that. Damned if this doesn't have suspicious written all over it. Ooh, those triangle seats. You're not totally comfortable with us, huh? Hey, hold on, how do you sit in these seats? So high up. If you feel like a drink after all, just let me know. No, apparently we're against all. You can go up here? Oh no, these are way too big for me. Seem eager to go, but what about your friend there? Oh. Put it back at 100. What is this fun place meant to be? Is Kiwa here? Well, I suppose there's only one way to find out. There we go. Gives you teeth? This area is normally off limits, but Kafkiwa has told us all about you. Just follow the corridor and head into the room at the end. Let's go, Rin. Whatever happens, you won't catch me being surprised. Why'd you say that? Not clearly.
Wonderful! They're here!
We've only just arrived ourselves.
Amazing!
Oh, it's a map? Blueprint? Map?
I bid you welcome to the back room. Oblivion's humble headquarters.
A hideout tucked behind a drinking hole. Brings back memories, doesn't it?
Sure does.
Our members here are mainly creators and adapters. That is, scientists and engineers who specialize in electrode. They use their skills to provide support to our field operatives. Geralt, Shale, be so kind as to give our friends an overview of your duties.
Geralt! How many
bears? All this provisioning. Gotta have supplies to fight the good fight, ain't ya? Luckily, we got the tools to craft most of what we need.
Gathering intelligence is another vital aspect of our work. Everkeep's core system is a veritable treasure trove of information. You just need to know how to get in and find it.
We also handle surveillance and communications, watching the enemy's movements and coordinating our own, that sort of thing.
And among all our activities, we spend a fair bit of effort investigating preservation. The organization credited with laying the foundations of electrope technology. From the soul management system to Everkeep's design, they're behind just about everything you see here. It'd be no exaggeration to say they made this realm what it is.
Hmm.
But their magnum opus was without a doubt the power which was used to join Alexandria to Tural. Interdimensional fusion.
Is there another Sid too?
Said power isn't unlike my summoning technique and the magic within Asim's crystal. Yet, though the effect is localized, to be able to fuse realities. Even with my knowledge, I struggle to conceive how it could be possible.
Incidentally, the founders of our group, a husband and wife, were members of Preservation at one point. But they opposed the fusing of worlds, and so defected in order to prevent it.
While not entirely unexpected, given what we have seen, this is still quite the revelation.
By the by, that's an interesting earring you have there. A novel way of carrying a data storage device.
Oh.
Oh, you didn't know. As a precautionary measure against machine infiltration, we scan everyone as they enter. And when we scanned you, we detected a small quantity of electrope.
Oh, damn.
Though it's been dressed up, that earring is a storage device and no mistake. Bought it from a shop here, did you?
No, it isn't bought, but inherited.
So these people sent you through the portal along with the earring.
Do you know aught of them?
Listen, Cryo. The husband and wife who founded our order. It's believed that they were Malala. Though we have no evidence at present, we can't rule out the possibility that they were your parents, or perhaps close relations.
Ooh.
This I posit because they were the very individuals who spearheaded the research into interdimensional fusion. As traitors to preservation, they were relentlessly pursued. If they had a child they feared they couldn't keep safe, entrusting her to the people of another world might have been their best option.
My parents, the founders of Oblivion. Tell me everything you know about them, no matter how small or seemingly insignificant. Anything and everything.
We don't even know their names, I'm afraid. In a bid to elude Preservation's agents, we suspect they erased all trace of themselves.
Except for the earring?
I'm sorry we couldn't be of more help. If you're interested, though, you're welcome to review our accumulated data.
Yes, please. As an individual and member of my order both, I wish to learn as much as possible.
I should also like to peruse the data. Where the joining of realities is concerned, I may well be of service.
Of course. Feel free to peruse to your heart's content.
Thank you.
If you like, I can examine your earring. I have to say, the prospect that it belonged to our founders has me itching to take a look.
I dare say we have enough eyes to pore over your records. Is there any other way we might be productive?
Wait, I want to be on the eyes team.
Not right now. We're still waiting for Zeralja to make the next move.
In that case, Alice, would you mind accompanying me?
Gladly.
Oh.
I'm bugging it up again!
Never a moment's peace. Pay him no mind. I don't.
Oi! You two there! One of you give me a hand, would you? Don't matter who.
Okay.
I just remembered I have matters to discuss with Shay.
Okay. Just me and Geralt again. Geralt. How many of him are they gonna make? This is the third reflection of him we've seen. Well, not reflect. Is it gonna give us our 99 equipment then? I would assume maybe that would be what's happening. Wait, I'm not 99 yet. Better you than me. You just threw me under the bus. Seldom does one see Kryla so openly impassioned. As her comrade, I will do my best to support her. Shale has already extracted the data on the earring. At long last, a clue. My apologies, but I will remain here to review the Why don't I get to... I'm more curious about this than Kryl. I feel for you. When Geralt is a brilliant adapter, it's as if he's stuck on full volume. It's all I can do to put up with the clamor. By the by, you didn't know him before, did you? Don't see how you could, but for a moment there, you were looking at him like you'd seen a ghost.
Yep.
A little. Try to keep closer to the rest of us, so you don't get surrounded.
Wait, I should probably read hers first.
When I go on the attack, do you think I'm pushing forward too quickly? Oh. She's getting combat advice from Alice. Oh!
I would love for this to be a Rising Stones. Is there... It's just the back room, so... If we can come and go from here, though?
Sorry you had to see me passion spilling over. That happens when you put your heart and soul into your craft, you know? And not to be weird or nothing, but I felt a sense of kinship when I saw you.
That doesn't make any sense. As if we'd met in another life. It wasn't another life. It's just a different you. Physically doesn't make sense.
Any road, as I was saying, I need someone to lend me a hand. I haven't slept for 2 nights now, not a single wink, and I'm ripe to collapse. Can't afford to, though. Got folks relying on me, see? But if I'm to keep at it, I need you to fetch me my favorite energy tonic.
That's it? You want a monster energy drink?
That voucher's good for 2 cans. One for yourself, by the way.
Oh, welcome.
Can't get the stuff at any old vending machine, though. You need to talk to the bloke named Philomon. You'll find him tending a bar out on the main strip. Off you go now.
That name sounds familiar. I don't know from where. Is it from another Final Fantasy or Persona lore?
Persona just popped into my head for some reason. It is absolutely Persona lore, and I will not go into it at all. For obvious reasons. Also, it's spelled different, so.
I do want to check up here really quick. Is that a dumpster? God, this is... There's so much I want to see. Where do I have to go? I have to go down to the main strip. I do want to check this back alley, but I guess I'll save that. This
as someone who lives in, near the Twin Cities, this kind of reminds me of some of the clubs in the Twin Cities. I'm sure it's a lot more common elsewhere, but I only know the Twin Cities. This establishment caters to lost souls seeking their true path. As a matter of fact, the services of our fortune-telling are in high demand of late. I'm afraid we're completely booked for the coming months. Fortune-telling? Oh. Never seen anything quite like it. And that's a good thing, right? This city certainly feels alive. What are you doing just standing here? Is this even... Oh, you're trying to meet someone. Easy now, gotta make this look natural. That's where you sell bikes. Melody. Don't get me wrong, Bonham's a brilliant mechanic and popular with the customers, but he wouldn't know a good business sense if it slapped him around the face. Take his latest invention, a rainbow-colored propulsion system. Who's gonna buy something like that? Whoa, look at that goatee.
Looking to overhaul your ride. Say no more. I'll have it tweaked and tuned and ready to roll in no time.
I gotta see your... I don't know why that looks so funny. They can do a lot with this for the post-patch stuff. This is gonna be an interesting, like, endgame hangout kind of nonsense. Especially with the things they can do with the dungeons and all that. I don't know if they'd really have one in Solution 9, though. Maybe. You ever tune yourself with a... Oh, yeah. Now we can go everywhere. Ooh, a fountain. Why are you not on? That is all that's over here. Okay. So are Katie and ever going to reopen? Not with the war going on, that's for sure. If the raid ends up being like just a casual tournament, it's going to be so weird. I wouldn't really mind, but it won't make the, like, because always, you know, every raid at the end, there's a boss that on Savage turns into like a super version, or, you know. But could you really do that with a tournament? Would it even feel the same? I guess I don't know. I'm going to see how they handle it. Never guess what it turned up the other day? Little critter goes, squeal? Don't be daft. There's bars everywhere. Hold on, we can go in here. Metcola. The hell is this? Oh, it's a clothing shop. All right, we'll talk to you. Welcome, what are you having? Energy tonics you can't get from vending machines. How dare you suggest I sell such dangerous stuff? Away with you. Away with you and don't come back. Got a voucher? Slip it to me, then. Nice and subtle. Ah, so you're collecting for Gnolt. A can for him and a can for you, eh? Apparently. Here you go. Yours is formulated for beginners. Gentler than the full-strength stuff? We're no beginner. It's not contraband or anything, so you won't run afoul from the authorities. But if the Rodina Consortium was made aware of my special selection, it'd be bad for business. Now, seeing as it's your first time, I want you to drink your tonic here, just in case there's side effects. What? Is that a dog? Bearing a curious design upon its can, it's okay. Okay, we drank it in a single pull. That's a bad idea.
That's how you do it. Pulls on a quicken soon, after which you'll start to see everything more clearly, and then finally you'll feel a roaring surge of energy. People say it's like growing a pair of rainbow wings. Well, you haven't up and carked it yet, so hurry on along and give him his tonic. Tends to leave it to the last moment. I expect he's about to keel over.
Oh, we're super powered. Why are we so... Why did you give me this visual animation? Oh, it's gone. Like, it wasn't a side effect or anything. It just happened for a second. Status effect, not side effect. Nope. Okay, these aren't updated. You guys are updated, though. What do you think of the crew here? An interesting bunch, right? I personally recruited Gnalt and Shale, by the way. We're learning about regulators at the moment. How are your errands coming along? Is it just me, or are there rainbows in your eyes? No. Just you. Nary a moment goes without... Gnalt moaning and grunting. I presume it's how he expresses his passion for his work. You got the tonic? Give it here, quick! Holy. Oh, that's the stuff. Ain't nothing like it to blow the cobwebs right out with a great big kaboom. Awaken something feral in me. It does. Transforms me into a remorseless beast that won't stop until it's done what it was born to do. Any road, sorry for sending you off on an errand like that. I just can't concentrate without me tonic, you know? And a pile of work only gets bigger, ever gets bigger. Speaking of which, I better get back to work. Those weapons and tools ain't gonna enhance themselves. Are you ever not a smith? All three reflections. Smith.
I've been meaning to ask about that Mamulja child. Could he be...
Yes. In all likelihood, he's Doralja's son.
How?
So you think so too. But what is he doing here?
He was abandoned, the poor dear. We found him in the drift downs a few years ago.
To think he'd cast aside his child.
We can't say for certain who he was born to, or why he was on his own. But he's a blue-scaled Hubigo, and Zoralja is the only other one around.
Yeah, but who?
That being the case, everyone assumes their father and son. Even the boy has put two and two together. This all happened when he was very little, so he has no recollection of his parents. It breaks my heart to think of it.
What's his name?
Guluja.
Aww.
It was my hope that he'd grow up to be a man of principle, like his grandfather.
It's a fine name.
I should mention that the boy is a little unusual.
How dare you?
At first, I intended to raise him as my own. But just when I thought he was warming to me, he suddenly disappeared. We searched high and low for several days. And where should he turn up? But in the wilds near Everkeep.
What? It's a miracle he didn't fall prey to fiends.
See? That's another unusual thing. Creatures don't seem to attack him. He could pick his way through the Thunder Yards as if he were on a stroll.
Oh.
On making inquiries, we learned that he had been living alone and receiving food from the people of the outskirts. This became something of a pattern. We track him down and bring him back, only for him to disappear again within a matter of days. He would return to the wilds without fail, and once again rely on the kindness of strangers to survive. Finally, I took the hint and left him be, giving him the solitude he prefers, and lending a hand only when he explicitly asks.
If Gulucha is Zorolja's child, that makes him my nephew. Assuming he's willing, I'd be glad to take him in like Papa did for me. But seeing as I'm here to kill his father, I don't know if it would be right.
Nope.
Who was that?
You just heard it.
Oh dear. It's Gulucha.
Don't tell me he heard everything.
Oh, this is my fault. I asked that he be kept away, but I should have taken more precautions.
I'm going after him. I need to explain.
Wait, Lamachi. I understand your haste, but it'd be best to coordinate a search.
It's only been 2 seconds.
Do you have any idea where he might go?
There's no telling, I'm afraid. He could as easily be outside the tower as here in Solution 9.
If those who can fight would search below, my mother and I will scour the district.
Sounds like a plan. Let's get to it.
Oh boy. So, obviously, for Mamulja, there has to be two parents. And this boy, if 30 years have passed, that means this boy had to have been born somewhat recently. So I'm a little confused. If he is, are there other Mamulja we don't know about here? Is that even a big question about this? I don't know. Or is it just he probably has a kid and just assume so? I don't know. Regardless of the circumstances, Zorolja is Gulucha's father. The boy is bound to be confused. That sentence is confusing. Worry not. The rest of us will keep our preparations moving along. You need but concentrate on finding him. I hope Gulucha will be alright. Should he return here, we'll be certain to let you know. Just Ja. I'm sorry, I should have noticed sooner. Nope.
I bet ye. Ye no good, never-ending pile of work, yarg. He doesn't even care.
Little footfalls.
If Gulucha is outside of the tower, we need to find him as quickly as possible. Even if he's used to getting around on his own, the wilds are still no place for a child. Agreed. While Krylan and Raha continue reviewing the data, the three of us should devote ourselves to the search. Alright, let's head to the base of the tower and take it from there.
I don't think we're in any super rush here, considering he can't be attacked. No one attacks him. God, there's so much I haven't explored over here. That's probably what's happening right now. We're gonna chase him into the other side somehow. I do have to go back up there, though. Alright, I'm probably gonna do that and then end. Thank you. Gemstones? Nothing. Nothing I care about right now. Okay. Why are you guys facing the entrance?
Heritage Found is a large area, and splitting up would allow us to cover more ground. Well, here we are outside, but where do we even begin?
There.
Perhaps someone has caught sight of Gulul Jha. Let's make inquiries nearby. Good idea. Could you handle the outskirts, LSA? In the meantime, Rinner and I will head beyond that big wall. Hell yeah. We're going past it. So is there any particular meaning behind Jha Jha and Jha in the name? I don't know. I'm guessing maybe there's a side quest or somewhere that explains that kind of thing. But like Zorel Jha and then there's Bakul Jha Jha. Does the double Jha mean two-headed? Like blessed sibling? Because Bakul... What was that one guy's name? Actually, there's no way that duty list will tell me. The other one from Wanderer's Palace Hard Mode and Gulul Jha Jha all have two heads. I don't know. Where have you gone, little one? Oh, what is that? Doesn't appear to be in the area. However, you catch sight of a group of people a short distance to the southwest. There? You spotted those people too, yes? Perhaps they've seen something. Come on. I turn this down slightly. Spire of Trial? Is that that? Oh. I'm telling ya. Umbral static is quite a vibe for weather. Damn. Who are you people? The things we find are used in one of two ways, for ourselves or passed on to others. We meet all sorts of interesting individuals over, and over time, we gradually build a network of contacts. But who are you? I can tell you got a good eye, and I'm not talking about your ocular capabilities. What I mean is that you seem to be well-suited for finding lost valuables, useful resources, and the like. Do you have a mind to become a reforger? I'm certain you'd go far. As a possessor of a good eye myself, I'd bet on it. So you're reforgers, huh? What's down there? Looks like some sort of salvage yard. Well, let's ask after Gulul Jha. Gulul Jha isn't here. Oh. You're looking down at something. You know the boy. Have you seen him? Oh, forgive me. I didn't know you were... That explains... Okay. That explains the neck. Interesting. No offense taken. My name is Tapu. My eyes may be useless, but my ears are sharper for it. I can recognize people by their footfalls, including Gulul Jha. So he didn't come this way. Where in the world could he be? I do not know your voices. Who are you to Gulul Jha, and why do you search for him? I'm family, though we're not related by blood. His father is my brother. I've only just met Gulul Jha, and we haven't had a chance to talk properly. But I'm about to do something that'll make him hate me, and I wanted the chance to explain. His father is your brother, then that means you're... Yes, I'm Wuklamat, the Vow of Resolve in Tuliolol. And I've journeyed here to bring my brother Zorel Jha to account for murdering our people and our father. When all said and done, Gulul Jha may not want nothing to do with me. Nonetheless, I'll always consider him family. I'll always be there for him, and I want him to know that. It tears you apart to do what you must. The quiver in your voice tells the tale.
Oh, well, I'm quivering because I'm screwing up words.
Gulul Jha was headed south. There he has a place that is close to a home, as close to a home as he knows. Find and bear your heart to him. Should he in turn bear his heart to you, accept and respect his wishes, as Queen Sveen respected ours when she granted us a place in her realm. I will, don't worry. But, what do you mean when you say she respected your wishes? Out of concern for her well-being, Her Majesty had urged us to reside inside Everkeep. When we declined, not only did she gracefully accept our decision, she granted us the necessary supplies to make our home here. And since then, she has paid us regular visits to see how we fare. Sounds like a sphene, all right. Well, thanks for telling me about Galuja. I'll find him, and then we'll have a good talk. We continue south, it seems, and let's keep our eyes peeled as we make our way. Can we inform Alice that she doesn't have to waste her time looking elsewhere? Think Pearl. Use it. Alright, what's over here really quick? Wait, what the... Why does this exist in this form? What do you lead to? Huh. I'm kind of curious about that. That seems like the way it's lined up there. Is that the dungeon? Or a dungeon? I guess we're kind of at the point where I'm going to get the 99 dungeon, and then the last area will probably have the 100 dungeon and the trial. And then in post game, we have two dungeons, I believe. And I have no idea what they would be or where they are. East. But if I had to imagine anything, this place definitely seems like it could have two dungeons. Also, a cowboy dungeon. I want one of those. Simply because we didn't have any, like, actual dungeon in that area. The hell's going on over there? Oh my god, everything is blocked? Oh. Oh. Hold on. What is happening over there? Oh, it's happening everywhere. They're lightning. What are those called? Founts? No, that's not the word. Blow up! Does it not blow up when you're near them? Oh, I was hoping I get to see it close. I don't think it's going to blow up when I'm near it. Northeast. Are they wearing armor? What are those? I mean, they're elephants, but... They kind of look mechanical. Oh, that's cool. This, I'm so curious. What's the name? Oh, there is no name. Ah. So that's the old Alexandria? That town square looked very familiar. Oh, right. 500 salt. How many do I have left? 3. God, that's a big section. Please tell me it's like the same layout and everything. I beg you. There's the clock tower. Wait, maybe. No, they're all over the place. Technically, that would be like another Alexander then. That was destroyed, if it's the same.
except a very, very different Alexander than the one we have in 14. It's a town. And half of it is submerged. The architecture looks nothing like we've seen so far, and it's more Charlian. Kinda. Ah, there he is, among the ruins. You only caught a glimpse, but there's no mistaking that tiny silhouette. Let's hurry after him. It'd be a disaster if a building collapsed while he was inside. Wait, so... this may be an unusual spot to end it here, but I'm going to end it right here and probably get extremely nostalgic in a minute. I highly doubt we there's no way we can actually, yeah, where I'm looking, we can't actually go. So we can't like investigate the castle or anything. But this square is fascinating. Actually, I wonder if that is a similar layout, because there's like the square and then you'd run along here. And right about here is where you get hit by Puck when you're playing as Vivi. And then someone's like, here, you dropped your ticket. And then you keep walking. And there's like a town hall or a bar on the right. And right over here, this section, would be the main central area of Alexandria. It's Alexandria. Yeah, with the gate that goes up to the castle back there. It's kind of in a similar layout, just by, you know. Actually, maybe not, because this. I don't want to think of it. I'm. Thanks for watching. Let me know if you like it, and I will see you in the next one.